What do you see? What do you see?
I see engineering beauty. I wonder who made this masterpiece of a bridge. The dimensions are so large. Like compared to looking around in a BIM model, you forget the dimensions. It's huge, it's enormous.
You could communicate your design. We were able to plan in a whole new way.
So it always surprises me when I get to site how large the scales are.
My name is Øystein Ulvestad. I'm a structural engineer. I've dedicated my life to BIM and trying to move from 2D to 3D. I've been a structural engineer for 23 years now. I started working with AutoCAD, doing 2D drawings of rebars, of stairs. I quickly got tired and bored of it because it was so tedious, and you have to do every change in three dimensions on three different drawings. When I discovered BIM, I was super excited because I could see that this was the future. The mantra that I tried to use is death to drawings. And in Norwegian, that would sound like død til tegninger. I do feel it sounds better in English though. It has a good ring to it.
Naviger til Kistefoss Museum.
So when I got my first car, navigation was analog. I would have to bring a book of old maps to navigate around Oslo. And at the same time, most design was done only by drawings and no 3D models. And the navigation technology and construction industry were both moving in a digital direction. So when planning your route while driving, it's pretty obvious that you would choose the digital version instead of the 2D maps. The same way I feel about construction, it's pretty obvious that you would want to choose the updated BIM models that's always current and has the latest information instead of the 2D blueprints that would be pretty fast would be outdated.
If you put every piece of information that you need in a BIM model instead of drawings, you'll always have updated information available for everyone involved in a project, which has massive benefits.
So my name is Tiago. I'm a bridge designer in Portugal. We were responsible for the design of the Randselva Bridge together with Sweco. We needed to create a team that was specialized not only in good engineering but also in modeling.
In an early working session where we sat down to get to know each other, the head designer, Tiago, he was used to presenting a design to draftsmen that maybe had 20 or 30 years experience. We didn't have experienced draftsmen because people knowing BIM and people knowing parametric design, they were straight out of university. So we presented this very young group of engineers, and I could see Tiago's face on the first meeting. He was quite worried. He did not understand how this group of people would transfer his vision and design into a BIM model.
Mm-hmm.